at such a time as this that we are not planned or intended for. Father, we come with grieving hearts, with sorrowful spirits. We come, Father, in shock, in distress. But yet, Father, you know and trust that you are still with us, even at.
Amen. Ngoba siyithe 25,000 angicabanga ukuthi umfundi sunayo. Amen. Sitawuzama ke bazalwane kwekuthi sibambe isikhathi. Silahlekelwe bazalwane kakhulu kusisiphingi. Mina ke ngimatisi isikhathi lesizanyana. Kodwa la ngafike ngambona khona ukuthi she's really a hard lady. We lost our sister in 2012. And I was talking to her and I said, "Yes, sister, we are thinking ehluleka mina kwamukela lento le." And then she said to me, "Lalela, I'm going to give you a very hard counseling. Angeke uphinze ubuye la kimi." And I was wondering ukuthi uthini manje sisiphi. Uthi lalela la. In life, life as a whole is like a train. Now give a stimela. Nasihamba le stimela nasifika station. Kuba khona la behlako. Bese siyaqhubeka le stimela. And then she said to me, le stimela nasemlayishile sisiwakho. Sifika same station. Kwathi ngeka kuthehle. And there's nothing you can do about it. Uthi noma ungakhala uthi gicide past, that was heart counseling. Noma ungakhala uthi gicide past, sekude lo ungakushintsha. Wathi nje ngushiya nalamagama lawo, ungaphindzi ubuye kimuntu ongikhalela. And I say, hey, I've never heard of such a counselor, but nje ekugcineni ngasitakala. Sithi ke kini ke bomasuku namuhla nani nonke dihlobo. Sisiphingi besigibele naye esitimele. We were all happy. Sicabanga kwekuthi sitawuhamba naye kule stimela. Size siyofika lezulwini la siyakhona. But unfortunately, besingasathi isiteshi sakhe. So sifikile le siteshi sewehlile. Sitawungakhala nje bazalwane but ke lokunye la.
To WhatsApp your senior management. And I wrote, I said, ngicela ukuthi sinake indaba ye-COVID. Let us strengthen precautions, a ministry. Let us tighten. Not knowing ukuthi lendiza le phaphako cruising at a high speed. Ngileyaka le lesson engine lesayifailile. And I really don't know. Kuthi nyalo kufuna siphume sibhekephi. Ithi GPS mina libito lami ngingilindiwe wakadlamini. Ngiwekutala lapha kazombotse ngamanzi. Ngitalwa ngemalangeni. Ngingumsabatha, sabathe kwaluseni. Le department ya guidance and counseling is the powerhouse of the Minister of Education. All the programs, the Bantuan, la improve the educational outcomes, apegwa lapha. Nangabeke, kuwa bo co-pilot, uyadibuda, kuthi, utawenda njani. Ngobe yona yafunza naye, imati ngachawo. So, namuhla we are just shattered. But, namuhla kufanele, sikhulu. Pingi was a hardworking person who brought joy to all our learners, our teachers, our head teachers, our partners. More so because they are taught on how to talk to people. Silile lenene lolbandla ngobe bekuthiwa nangabe kune request yokuthi career guidance sithi awukhona Pingi. Will take it up. Sibilile na lamanye mabas bo Smith na Bonhlani. Bazalwane ngifisa kusho ukuthi Nami ngati kalela, ne department siya ikalela. Nisibanfaba matutu, they are here, Lindelwa, Bali, Deni, Makoti, Mkwenyana, angala shlegelwa notwa. Nazi si la shlegelwe. A prayer warrior. I can highlight one instance. There was a time la pumoya bo vungi, les vung vung. Sifuna kusthata, uti I guidance and counseling ingangene dikolweni. They went back ekhaya labafundiswa khona. They asked for a prayer. And I was so fortunate because there was my sister in that prayer band. She also picked up and she asked me, kuthi what is happening? I mean, I don't know. And we managed to launch successfully. Namhla sikhuluma i-guidance and counseling program isetikolweni ngenxa yemthandazo walabantwana bakamasuku. And silahlekelwe ngudokotela wethu lolokubuhlungu because Pingi was caring for everyone. I shared with her around mhlaka 15 kutsi my son is positive. She gave me tips. She gave me lots of things kutsi angende lo. So he pulled through. No masuma workshops bega khona kutsi so hambile yokhuluma nebase hotel taking care of everyone in the department. Loko ke kusifundzisile kutsi siyadzinga kutsi sinakekelane. We have a program that will take care of the carers. Sithi ke bonhlane masuku sihlaselekile siyabona kepha kuneli verse lengifisa kunishiya nalo lapha ku Revelation 21 verse 4 ithi he will wipe every tear from their eyes. Nyalo siyayibona njengoba ashito umzalwane wethu maphala la kuthi sedikhathi tekugcina. Say me hello le. It's about to be birth. So, sengathi ke bantfu bami. I'll urge you Bali Lindelo Makoti Deni Mkhwenyana kuthi ningasuki kuNkulunkulu. Pingi ukwentile lokufanele kuthi anifundzise. Siyadililela, siyanililela. Amen.
Siyabonga baka nomele ngathi noma ngidirector noma umele director ngidirector ha yibonini tiende kathi nje emhlabeni siyambonga nkulunkulu kulesikhathi samanje sitawucela lota ukukhulume la bangani siyakhumbula abazalwane ukuthi sithe umfundisi simnika li hour angithi so sitawucela ke lalaba khuluma ko mane ba shayita ihloko ngiye ngithi ke mine hey uyahlupha la kuma memorial service because letinye taletindvo lesikhuluma lana asitikhuluma umuntu asaphila kuba ngathi uyasiva uyasibona ukuthi kwendekani kanti cha iBhayibheli alikufundisi lokho sicela lokuthi awukhulume labangani.
Anginivusele bekunene endlini nani nonke libito lami ngibuyelele ngwakadlamini sibongo and ngitokhulumela abangani baPinki Ngiyacabanga ke ukuthi everyone gathered here today was Pinky's friend. But then again, each person has that one special or two friends. Labange ma confidante, soulmate, and the people or the person that has known you all your life. So in Pinky's case, it was Buyelele and Utombolo Masilela. Dombolo is in Joburg, and Utemageva Gutuhambile Sisuetu Sati Asipale Ngobane Bantwana Nabo Bati Bantula Bati Mama is Buyelele and Dombolo from childhood. And Unomama ka Pinky Magafona Naye was Lilela, Watting and Lilela Buyelele and Dombolo. So we wrote a letter, an open letter to our best friend. Dear Chow, Besimbita Chow, Pinky, it's almost a week since the day we received the dreadful news that you have left us to be with the Lord. Our New Year's celebration turned into a dull moment instantly. We realized that after 48 years of knowing you and sharing our lives with one another, we would never see or hear from you again. It was in January 1974 when we all entered through the gates of St. Michael's Primary School to start our grade one. We were all 6 years old or turning six that year. It was five of us who were boarders in grade one. Buyelele Dlamini, myself, Helen Hutchinson, who was from South Africa, Maso Vilakazi from Soweto, Dombolo Masilela, and you, precious Masuku. If memory serves me well, we all wet our beds in that first night. We were for the first time in our lives away from our loving families, and at that young age, on our own. Mother Martha, whom we fondly called Mother Martha, because that's what we thought she was called, was the matron in the girls' hostel. She welcomed us and took us under her wing. She would put all five of us in a tub and bathe us, brush our teeth, and dress us up neatly to ensure that we are ready for school. We bonded from that year on. Think about this. You know, in those first 7 years of primary school, there's 365 days in a year, and it's in a, we literally spent 300 days per year, season three. So you can imagine the bond that I create. It was a bond that nothing could break except death. We did everything together. We had our special rhymes and songs that we would reminisce whenever we met to bring back the six-year-olds we once were. We also remembered how on weekends, Sister Grace, the headmistress, would sit us down and teach us how to write letters to our parents and pen friends. Abawate ma pen friends la balamus. Pen pals. Bakulumagu WhatsApp. We would literally recite those letters when we met in our adulthood. For example, Sasiti, dear mommy and daddy, how are you at home? I am fine here at school. And it would go on and on. As the years progressed, probably in standard two or three, Helen and Maso left for South Africa, and we were left, the three of us. We continued to grow up together, went into high school together, and entered into puberty together. We knew each other like the back of our hands. We eventually finished our high school in 1985 and branched our different ways as we explored the outside world. However, our bond was cemented. We were like triplets. Whenever we were together, we celebrated each other's achievements, and we were cheerleaders for one another. You know, I said to Dombolo, D, I don't know ukuthi kunjani makushoni phahla, but what I feel today is ngathi khona okuhlephukile. You know, when you look at the years we've spent with Pinky and the days and nights, everything till today is sihlukana. But as the years went by, I discovered that Pinky was my cousin. Okay? And it even sealed a bond here to even further. So we had this special language, you know, Pinky, that we picked up on our first visit to Joburg. You know, saye goli sabuya sesikhuluma isiZulu nomzala. Abazumzala nje bayazi ukuthi hayi ke. Waze wacela ukukhuluma le language le efonini ukhuluma nobuyi. So ngikhumbula nje one time besise dropheni eGoli. Pinky was a sharp dresser. And we'd look at these ladies from Soweto, bebangena ngo Market Street, those years in the 80s, ngama taxi, behle ma taxini, and then Pinky would be like, wow, boy, pega, pega lo ya sis lo ya mzala, pega utukogeni, yo, purple and orange, yo, yo, yo. So she, you know Pinky. All right. And what I'd like to say is that Pinky was a beautiful soul and a God-fearing woman. Ubakhulisile abantwana bakhe umzala ngendlela eqotho enkonzweni. I've been there, I've seen it. You know, abo Deni base bancane banabo 12 years, bebabo brother Deni. Angena enkonzweni uDeni agcoka isuit netie njengoba nimbona. And the way umzala respected her children is a lesson to womanhood. Bahloniphile abantwana bakhe uPinky kakhulu. And we admire that in her. So what we'd like to say, Nodi, is that in our last conversation with her, that was manje ngo December 27th, Pinky told us, you told us you were not well and that you have started treatment and you were getting a reaction from one of the major drugs. You said it's fine because the EPR team and doctor did a home visit and gave you a shot. You sounded very positive, and we held on to the strength you portrayed in our conversation. We had so much assurance that you will overcome. Indeed, death is a weird thing. One moment you are talking and giggling, and the next you are on your knees crying. It hits like a train, even though it takes forever to actually realize that the person you were so close with is gone and not coming back. What I know is that we are facing in anything that we do or we did. Quitting and giving up was not in our vocabulary. So Chow displayed this to her last day. All we have now are memories of us, photographs, WhatsApp voice notes, just to hear your voice and remembrance of your Facebook page. That is all that's left of you, besides the children. You left this earth for God knows what reason. Only God knows that reason. But he took you away too soon. We are only girls, turning 53 this year, for Christ's sake. How we wish there was a sign. Chow, we don't think you understand just how much happiness you brought to so many people. You could light up a room you walked into with that personality and larger than life laughter. Nobody was a stranger to you. Everyone was a friend. You have left a huge vacuum here on earth because you still had a lot to offer, especially to our youth and our children. Nesin Bontlan, Nesin Besutum Swat, Nesin Bosmuth, Nesin Bosmith. On behalf of the St. Michael's girls, the class of 85, We'd like to say good night to our beloved sister and friend. Joy shall come in the morning. May your soul rest in eternal peace and rise in glory. We will miss you, Dombolo and Buyelele.
Siyabonga kulabakhulumela abangani solo ngihleti njelana ngiyalalela tonke letinkulumo labatishoko tiliqiniso ngase siphinge. She was just everything. Enkonzweni was a quiet person but akhuluma very observant abone netintfo lesingadiboni thina sibaholi bova nje sakhwe bathi u uyabona la kuthi kuyonakala la. Ukuthi uyadumangala ukuthi sowubone njani wena. She had ngathi la mehlo akha ngathi bekanani. Kulesikhathi samanje sithola si special item from Zwane family. Bakhona yini? Okay. Wotani bomangweni. Emva kwaloko sithola si light alunge Lindelwa with an obituary.
Ngithanda ukunibingela nonke egameni lika Jesu. Amen. Kumphathi sihlelo bafundisi nabo bonke kakhulu bemdzeni. Lona ngumfundisi Mlungisi Zwane from International Missionary Society, Seventh-day Adventist Reform Movement. Site la Pinkisi Madi as early as born 1983 umasikhula, maybe when I was to be baptized, being a youth leader in the church, she was my assistant. And when we grew up, we had a big challenge, especially on the issue of music. You could witness all who knows her, who knew her, ukuthi she had that golden voice, ekushaya phakathi noma kungasi lucky star. And you could see that now has been translated to kubantwana bakhe, but then bayincelile lento enanjeni ebeleni. Yes. It is so sad ukuthi we could come to this point, but ngithanda ukunipha an assurance what she believed in. In the book of Revelation, chapter 16, verse 17, there we find that there will be a voice of God that will sound at the pore of the seventh plague. And the Bible says that voice is going to shake the heavens and the earth. There will be a great earthquake. And in that earthquake, the graves will be opened. As Jesus died upon the cross, when he died and asked Jesus Christ, it is done, the graves were opened and there are people who came out. So it is that hope that our dear sister will be resurrected. And according to what we believe, that God himself is going to tell us the day and the hour of the coming of Jesus. I want us to share something written here, that our time here on earth is short. We can pass through this world but once. As we pass along, let us make the most of life. The work to which we are called does not require wealth or social position or great ability. It requires a kindly, self-sacrificing spirit and a steadfast purpose. A lamp, however small, if kept steadily burning, may be the means of lighting many other lamps. Pinky was that steady lamp. We have but a brief lifetime here. We know not when the arrow of death may strike our hearts. We know not how soon we may be called to give up the world and all its interests. Eternity stretches before us. Like David, our prayer should be, Lord, teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Amen. With me is my wife and our last born. Would like to, just to render a special item for us, not for her, but in memory of her. Amen.
Just like you promised, you came there to stay. I just have to pray. And Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried, and I strove to remind you that for those Jesus, I give you my heart and my soul. I know that without God I'll never be whole. Savior, you opened all the right doors. I thank you, praise you from earth humble shores. Take me, I'm yours. And Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cry, and I strove to remind you that for those strove to remind you that for those tears I died.
Siyabonga umndeni wakaZwane umculo labasinikete wona lo sikhuthatako kwekuthi Jesu soloko uthi asideni kuye kulesikhathi samanje sikutawudlala ke ma slide la emva kwaloko sitawucela Lindelwa etengembile ato sifundzela umlando wasesiphingi. Are we done? Thank you. Siyabonga bazalwane. Kodwa kunye lengidawufuna ukubuta lana kulabantwana ukuthi ngubani obekafundisa sisiphinga ivosho. Angizange sengimbona jayifa mina. Angathi mhlambe nguwe deni ngiyakusola. Kulesikhathi samanje sida ucela lo tawu sifundzela umlandvo wakhe. Bese balunga kodwa ukhulumela bakankambule, kodwa ukhulumela bakadlamini, kodwa ukhulumela bakamasuku. Sikhathi bazalwane sesihambe kakhulu, ngibona bemthetho lapha sengiyesaba abatawuze babophe.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. I'll be reading the obituary. Pinky Precious Masugu was born on the 10th of April 1968 in Hlatikhulu. She attended her primary education at St. Michael's in 1974 and proceeded to St. Michael's High School, where she completed her O-level in 1985. She then proceeded to the University of Swaziland, now Eswatini, where she enrolled for her bachelor's degree in humanities from 1986 to 1919. After university, she began her career as a high school teacher at Dwaleni High School, Gakombe. Thereafter, transferred to Christ the King High School. It is during her time as a teacher that Pinky's passion on counseling and career guidance was brought to life. She then left teaching and joined the Educational Testing Guidance and Psychological Services, ETGPS, as career guidance and counseling officer stationed at Nhlangano. After a few years, she transferred to Manzini ETGPS office, where she still practiced as a counseling officer. In the year 2019, she then moved to Mbabane office, where she has been stationed until the time of her demise. Pinky's passion for her job saw her not only extending a hand to the children who needed guidance and counseling, but also to some of the private companies which would seek her counseling skills for their staff. She was sought after by different church denominations to talk on key issues affecting the youth, an area she did with so much vigor and enthusiasm. Outside of her work life, Pinky enjoyed sewing, singing, and spending time with her family. She was such a loving person to all people from all walks of life that she impacted. She is survived by her three children, Mbali, Denny, and Lindelwa Smith. Her two granddaughters that she adored, Mahle and Milani Dlamini. Her parents, Mage Miriam Masugu and Babe John Masugu. Her siblings, three brothers and one sister, and three sisters-in-law. Lala Ngekuthula Sugu, your memory will forever live in us. The heavens are rejoicing. Thank you.
Siyabonga umlandvo wasisi. Sitawucela ke nabala balandzelako labathathu. Ngeke ngibabite, batawuta nje ngekulandzelana. Bakankambule, kulandzele bakadlamini nebakamasuku. Sicela silandzelane ngaleyo order le.
Angilibingelele bazalwane egameni lenkosi yethu Jesu. Ngithunywa bakankambule kuto tikhalela ngiphinze ngikhalele naso sonke sivele besi banzakanye naye Pingi kuloku hamba kwakhe ngendlela esidume kakhulu nanyalo sisemangele asikhona lokuthi sitawuthi kepha kwendeke njani ngoba sibabonile abantu basinza kulesifo bese themba nathi ukuthi sathi wethu tawuphunyula kepha kusalile uNkulunkulu uyadena ukuthi liplan lakhe belini ngaye ngithi thina lesiselela emhlabeni lebesicabangela ukuthi kutawuhamba ngale ndlela esifisa ngayo kani akukavami lokuthi kwendeke ngale yakho indlela kuhamba ngale yakho umdana. Kunengilesenikushito ngathathe wethu angeke nganze ngalokunenga ngaphandle nje ukuthi she was such a darling, she was so ethical, bowathi ukuthi nakathi Bingi A akasho sindli enjang A bowathi futhi ukuthi utakutshela into le takusita angeke akudwisa akufake ehlathini. Ngithanda ke kubonga bantu abakhe labathe basi informa nathi basikhipha abreast lokuthi sibe sathi lokuthi kuhamba njani singayiva nje ukuthi ithathe wethu so unjani ngoba ugcina ngasakhona lokudikhulumela. Sibonge baka masuku kukhulisa such a wonderful woman like the way she turned out. Sibonge nje nabo bonke abantu labakhonile kuta namhla labekasebenta nabo bangani netihlobo. Sisho ke nakubomshana sithi bomshana we are so sorry sisaba nekunibuka ukuthi makweni akasekho. Kepha lokuhle ngako konke makweni bekanisa esontweni. Lisondo liyiphila emuntu kule khasi ledibi lesiphila kido. So siyacela bomshana ukuthi impela ningalilahli lisondo. Ni lilende libe insika yenu empilweni. In conclusion bekunene ngicela nje kunibonga nonke ukuthi nikhonile kuyekela imisebenzi yenu leminingi ngoba kusekhasi neliviki nato khona lokubambisa laba kamasuku kunaku lokubahlekele siyabonga.
Ngicela kunibingelela bazalwane nonke ngetigaba denu egameni lenkosi. Amen. Ligama lami ngingiselibhidlamini. Ngisuka esigangeni lapho khona kudalwa make waphingi khona inkosi kayibe nathi. Bakankosi bangithumile bathi kangisho ukuthi bomasuku nani bonkambule noma nathi sitililela sibaka nkosi kodwa bathi banililela kakhulu nkosi yami kwenqa emhlabeni kwaPhinki Pinky bekungumuntu webantu bonke nawuhlangene naye bekuphelele konke inkosi kayibe nathi etingqondweni tethu bazalwane kuba naloko ukuthi it's too early uhambe early kakhulu kodwa kubuye bese kuba nembhalo lothi usesesibelethweni senyoko ngakwadi lokho uthi useselihlwili kwancunywa tinsuku takho te kuhamba emhlabeni konke kwendeka lapho sine ke bazalwane siva buhlungu ngoba siphila enyameni inyama ihlala ibuhlungu onke malanga nenhlitiyo yathinzeka nje iba buhlungu kodwa ke bazalwane sine kukholo lokuthi this was the time sankulunkulu ngoba uthi nkulunkulu konke kunesikhathi sako inkosi kayibe nathi ekuze kuthi singatuli mata tingqondo kakhulu kumbele tifo lesetikhona setilethe iconfusion etingqondweni tethu iconfusion lethi sesiblawa yini kanti letinye tinfo nkulunkulu utivumela ngoba bese kusikhathi sathi ukuthi tendeke nkulunkulu noma kungathiwa bakudlise shevu lomadima kanganani masingakafiki isikhathi sankulunkulu siyakholwa lokuthi ngeke kwendeke lutho kuwe kodwa ke nase sifikile abazalwane kude longakwenda kufuna sivumele lokho asithi nje sibanga ngose bazalwane bakamasuku Nkosi yami akubanjiswane siyakholwa ukuthi kusele abantwana Nkosi yami akubanjiswane inhlitiyo ihlala la kushisa khona kuhlala kubhlungu siphelane asibambisaneni nkulunkulu utasisita emagama athi mina ngingumelusi lolungile lothela kuphila kwakhe ngenxa yetimvu bomasuku asiyene kumelusi lolungile long Jesu utawuselusa kulesikhathi lesimadima kangaka emalangeni angithumele ko inkosi ibuse amen
Etuzenes pambano gunom tombo mu uhle amanzi ogwela pa evela guchesu
angithatha lelithuba ubingelele umphathi lihlelo ubingelele bafundisi ubingelele nemindeni yonke lekhona enkonzweni egameni lika Jesu ngwaka masuku sibongo ngithunya ngiboba kamasuku lakhaya ngidawutsela kamasuku sebaphela bonke labadzala kodwa nje ngekusithwa nguNkulunkulu solo sikhona sitonqestelana tihlobo tethu base bamasuka sitonqestela nonke bongambule bongosi nani bonhlane dududekani kuleti khathi leti madima kangaka sitonqestela sibuhlungu sonke sishacekile uma sithola umbiko ngathathu wethu Pink ukuthi akasekho kusi limadileka kakhulu kodwa ngekusitwa nguNkulunkulu ngoba live la nguNkulunkulu liyaqinisana kwathi ukuthi tikhona tikhathi letifana leti letawufika ngulona lo ufuna hlala lungele ngoba sikhatha ngasadi sitothi nje kakhulu bomshana siyabonga ngoba makwenu bekungilolinye lihlobo lomuntu ngiyacabanga ukuthi bonke mina nje abengibitha ukuthi M4 vele nje bekuyindlela yakhe abehlala njanjalo ena bongeke uguqule lokho kuye ngoba uNkulunkulu umuntu umupha ngekumupha kwakhe so ngidothi bomshana Qinani enkosini nasemandleni ayo lamakhulu. Makweni unikhombisile indlela lengiyo. Chubekani nikhonde nkulunkulu. Futhi nawufunza levi maHebheru 10:35 lithi ningasilahli sibinzi sekwethemba nkulunkulu. Umthemba etimeni letifana naleti kuthi unkulunkulu khona utawuba nani bomshana sikhona nathi sibomalimo wenu sitawuba nani sinivusele sinisekele nangemthandazo kuze nkulunkulu atochubeka anigcwalise ngamandla. Kunemagama lakhulunywe ngumarket director la lasebenza naye lapha encwadini yasambulo chapter 21. Ngithanda la magama lawakhulumile lapha kulo verse 4 uthi yakwesula tonke tinyembete emehlweni abo sekuyawubathe kufa nekulila nekukhala nebuhlungu ngoba kwakuqala sekwendlulile. Ngifuna kugcizelela kunamagama nanga ukuthi lokwekuqala lokho lo lokuthenjiswa uNkulunkulu uthi utawude sula tinyembedi emehlweni ethu lokusho ukuthi sekuyabathe kufa lele sikubona namhla kuyabe sekude ngale la siyakhona. So sitothi asiqiniseleni tihlobo tethu noma sihlaselwa noma kwendekani empilweni tethu umuntu ngilona loyo akathi nje Nkosi ngifuna kufela kuwe ngoba sethikhasi tekugcina lethi futhi kude longathi thambiza longathi nje akamkhondi uNkulunkulu awungawu yatibambelela ngoba sekubonakele ukuthi ngilona loyo kufuna sonzele kuKristu dikhathi lethi madima lethi lodako uyabuya ngeka libale ushile evini lakhe ukuthi uyabuya masinyana. Sithothi ke cinani nonke tihlobo tethu uNkulunkulu abe nathi asiphe amandla kulesikhathi lesimadima kangaka egameni lika Jesu. Amen.
Esipha
siyabonga kubaka amasuku lati ndvotendeke emhlabeni bengingamadi masuku ukuthi ku-related nani bengimbuka njengemuntu nje kodwa sengibonile ukuthi Swaziland mncane. Siyabonga babe masuku emafe kukhutsata bazalwane kunanamaphepha nanga then waphethe bayacela lapha eminyango ukuthi ucela ubhale i-seat number yala uhleti khona uma siphuma lamaphepha siwashiye lapha eminyango ngoba laba ka COVID baye bafune kwathatha bawabuka. Kulesikhathi samanje sitawucela special item sibuya kumsimisi sithole. Okay, emva kwaloko sitawucela naba labalandzelako sesiyangasekugcineni. Ngesi mfundisi Nkosi yami labantu bakho sitawuba khona lo tokhulumela abantwana ma siblings bobani kodwa wo bakubo. Okay, bese kuba khona lo tokhulumela abantwana sesigcina ke ngalo tokhulumela libandla labe kahlanganyela khona sisiphing sitawuhamba nje ngaleyo order leyo nakacetha nje ebhuti sicela lo bathi tengibabe masuku tawusonzela ngembili emva kwakhe kude lo tokhulumela abantwana bese sekutokhuluma lolomele libandla.
Greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus. I'd like to express my sincere condolences to the Masuku family, the Smith family, and every single person who loved and was loved by Aunt Chow. I know that she was loved by many people because my mom was one of those people. Beka puma endlini ya stressed. Athi ngiyabuya after 30 minutes. Abuya after 5 hours. Asitshele ukuthi bekana Aunt Chow and her demeanor had changed. So I know that a lot of people have lost Aunt Chow. And I just really love to express my sincere condolences. And I hope this song helps you find comfort.
I know a place I can always run to in times of distress and confusion and fear. And when my enemies surround me, God, I know in you I'm safe. For you keep me and hide me in the shadow of your wings. I know a place. In times of distress, confusion and fear, and when my enemies surround me, Father, I know in you I'm safe, for you keep me and hide me in the shadow of your wings. In the shadow of your wings, I know I am safe. In the shadow of your wings, I'll find relief. For you hold me, God, you guide me with your righteous scent. I'll find rest, peace of mind, in the shadow of your wings. The Lord is my shield, he is the healer of my soul. He's my tower of strength, my redeemer, my keeper. And when my heart is filled with sorrow, for you're the lifter of my hand, you surround me with favor, and you satisfy my soul. 'Cause in the shadow of your wings, I know I am safe. It's in the shadow of your wings I'll find relief. For you hold me, God, you guide me with your righteous hand. I'll find rest, peace of mind in the shadow of your wings. 'Cause I am safe in the shadow of your wings. God, I am safe in the shadow of your wings. Yes, I am safe in the shadow of your wings. God, I know I am safe in the shadow of your wings. Oh, I know I'm safe in you, God. Is in the shadow of your wings, I know I am safe. It's in the shadow of your wings, I'll find relief. For you will hold me and you guide me with your righteous hand. I'll find rest, peace of mind in the shadow of your wings.
Amen.
Ngibingelela nonke eligameni lika Jesu Kristu inkosi yethu. Ngithanda bangithumele ukuthi ngikhulume le ma siblings. Akusimi lo lobhalwe lana, angicabangi ukuthi akukabi liphutha lokho. Angisi lo gifted ekukhulumeni. So I think you'll have to bear with me. But what I will say, niyangiva mos. Okay. Ngithi what I will say is that as a brother, as she was my sister, she's always been an older sister to me. And I think she was an older sister to all of us at home. And as an older sister, she did everything that an older sister would do for her siblings. I remember as early as 1979, when I went to St. Michael's, she was already there as a senior. But I always knew that I could trust my sister. Whenever I was bullied, I'd always go to her. And she'd always be supportive of me. She's done the same for all of us at home. And she's played her role as expected. I would say her cooking I'll always miss, because she always made the best vegetarian dishes you can think of. And funny enough, I still can't believe she's gone. Because I remember the day she went into Mbabane Clinic. I was actually, smiling, though she couldn't talk to me at the time. But I didn't think she wasn't going to pull through. So I'm still having a hard time believing that she's really gone. But I think the Lord knows what the plan was from the very beginning, and I think we just need to accept that. I've known my sister to be a powerful person and a loving person. I've never known her to keep grudges in all the time that I've known her. So whenever I needed support, even now, when I needed to talk, I knew that I would go to her, and she'd always give me the right advice and just tell me to cool down whenever I had problems. But then I know a lot has been said about her, and I fully agree with the person that they've said she is. And I would like to thank everyone that came out today, everyone that is here today, that has supported us as a family. I'd like to thank all the family members, that is the Masugus, the Dlaminis, and the Nkambules. I'd like to thank the friends that are here today, and all the church members from the Seventh-day Adventist and RTA. And I'd like to thank her colleagues. To her children, Bomshana, we will always be there for you. Whenever you have problems, you can always count on us. Okay, that's all I'd say about her. Thank you.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. I think it was quite obvious that I would be the one to represent my siblings today. Not only because I'm the oldest, but because I was a favorite. I hope you guys know that. I stand here before you confident that she completed her mission here on earth. And we are all so proud of our mommy. I'll never forget the voice of the lady who called me to tell me that you were no more. I'll never forget it. It seemed like a dream at first, but as the days pass, it will become so real. You're really gone. Seeing your body this morning, as well, I had to remind myself that it was just your vessel here on earth. Your beautiful spirit lives on. Telling my siblings, I feel, was the hardest thing I've ever had to do. But mommy, you would have been so proud of all of us. Lynn has surprised me so much. She's been so strong. God has surely been renewing our strength every day. Today he gave me a double portion because he knew I would need it. Mommy, we know you always used to doubt yourself and feel down because you never got the chance to build a home for us. But we want you to know, Mommy, that God will never bless us all in the same fashion. Your blessings and riches were in the many children that you had. This includes all your adopted children. Some of them are here today. Your son-in-law, your daughter-in-law, and your beautiful grandchildren that adored you so much. I want you to know that we've been okay. We've been okay because we've had each other. We have been each other's strength. I'll go as far as to say we've never felt closer. We have been together ever since you left us, sleeping in the same room. We've been comforting each other and making each other laugh. We promise to hold on to one another. We promise to be there for each other. We promise to look after your tumbu, Linz. We hope we have made you proud and will continue to make you proud. Thank you for everything that you did for us, Mommy. Everything you sacrificed for us. But most importantly, thank you for the values that you instilled in us that we now wish to uphold more than ever. Thank you for giving us Jesus. We will hold on to him so that one day we can meet in heaven. God really does have a sense of humor, because I always imagined that we would have to slaughter 5 cows to feed people at your funeral, because you were such a people's person, Mommy. But he had to take you during this pandemic where people can't even join us in sending you off. Walking in town with you was such a nightmare. Stopping every 5 seconds to greet people. You were such a people's person, Mommy. You left a piece of sunshine with you everywhere you went. We miss you so much, Mommy. We wish we could dance with you one more time. We miss your jokes and just your beautiful aura. We miss teasing you, naso zunda, uzenzumchozana. But we will let you go, because God called you, and we cannot question it. I'm no longer afraid of death, if it means meeting you again one day. Enjoy heaven, Mommy. Live like the princess that you are. Rest, my love, with love from Emakalati Ako, as you used to call us. Till we meet again, Pinky girl. Thank you.
Kosi sihla angene kuyo indlu uyakho woza nawe sesingene ebu
Asinibingelele nzambama egameni lenkosi yethu Jesu Kristu. Bazalwane, ngiwakasibeko sibongo sami. Ngicelwe libandla lasembabane Seventh Day Adventist. Kokokuthi ngitokulikhulumela ngekuhamba kwaPinki. I will just say a few things. Le Pinki bekangito. But before ngihlala phasi, I will read a tribute written by one of the Pathfinders. Laga begaba kanselisha babantwana bakhe. Who was Pinky? Pinky was a woman of virtue, a woman of God, loved God and feared his word. Bubble self, always. I've never seen Pinky in another face or a mood. Positive energy that would motivate you even if you were feeling down. A never changing person. A people's person. That was Pinky to the church. Had passion for children, pathfinders, and youth. Pinky wouldn't mind noma bangamsukumisanini uthi ngicela ukhulume nebantwana. She would jump at the opportunity. And also nanathi sibadzala. At church siye sitibite ngema girls. Laba baka women's ministry sithi ngema girls, but Pinky was a different girl. A girl that would help all of us see understand and lokuhle ngaPinky advices and motivations. She always referred us to the Bible, the Holy Word, the Holy Book. Pinky was always available to do God's work. No complaint, no murmuring, that was Pinky, with a smile. A spirit-led and guided counselor. Pinky was a counselor wetincwadi, but Pinky was a counselor wasekhaya ezulwini. Because always bekakutshela ukuthi sekwendekile konke. God is there. Trust in him. A mother to the young and a sister to all of us. As a church, we fellowshiped with Pinky on the, I think it was the 19th. We were with her church, bubbly as ever. We talked, we remained, we talked for some time. She has left a void that no other can fill except God himself. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 is a verse that sometimes confuses me. But this verse, to me in times like this, because I know the God that we served and Pinky served is a God of love. The verse says, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, said the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end." And 12 says, "Then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. And ye shall seek me and find me, when ye search for me with all your heart." Danny, Bali, Lindelwa, Makoti, Nemkonyan. "And ye shall seek me and find me, when ye shall search for me with all your heart." God is saying to you, when things are dark, when there are no answers, just do this, seek God with all your hearts, and you shall find him. Because he says he never leaves us nor forsakes us. Bazalwane, we have lost as a church. I will say again, we have lost as a church. But ngulungulu uyati koko kutsi kumele kwende kanjani. Sengihlala phansi. Lithi libandla. Remember the words of the prophet Isaiah in chapter 40, verse 31. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Bantfu bam, bambani lapho. Bomasuku bonkambule, the church and everyone. Pinky lived to be an example of a child who trusts in the Lord. Siyabonga bazalwane.
Siyabonga ku Make Sibeko kukhulumela libandla lasembabane sesiyangasemaphethelweni bazalwane sidawucela umfundisi Mashwama nekungiyena abuke libandla lasembabane utasiniketa livi kulesikhathi samanje. Amen.
Sele lithuba ngibingelele bazalwane ngamen na Jesu Christu. Amen. Ngibingelela especially baka Smith nebaka Masuku. Dihlobo tonke letitsinzekile nebangani labe ba close naye. Livi letfu lesitalfunza litawusuka encwadzini yakubase Korinte sahluko 15. Stawufunza verse 56 na 57. Kufunzeka kanjena. Lutfonsi lwekufa sono nemandla esono ngumthetho kodwa akabongwe uNkulunkulu losinika kunqoba ngenkhosi yethu Jesu Kristu inkhosi buso sekufundwa kwelivulayo. Amen. Asithandazeni Jehova mdalo emazulu nemhlaba sesilifunzele livu lakho sisengakakhulumi ngalo simema wena namoya wakho loyingcwele kuthi ngathi kungaba nguwo lo hola konkhosi sisalukhulumisa ube sesoyabathinzayo babhandisha abantu abakho lapho sitha ukukhuluma singafinyelele khona chubeka ngama wakho lo ingcwele ufinyelele khona siyacela lokho ngegama Jesu Kristu. Amen. Sisahamba lapha emhlabeni kunekuhlupheka lokunenge. There's a lot of suffering and try as we may we can run but we can't outrun it. Siyadama sibaleke but lamadubane ethu akakushiyi. It always catches up with us. And then kwasi sekufika na COVID. Today as I speak, even though it is midweek, kunemingcwabo and my memorials all over the country. Baningi laba lokuhlupheka lokufana nalokho. So it always catches up with us. And if you try to trace it, ema roots ago wathola lapha encwadini ya Genesis makungena sono kungena nekufa. So the root of all our suffering is sin, and that's why lama verse lesicetsa kwafunda makes sense to us today, because these verses tell us that we have victory over sin. Christ gives us victory over the root of the problem that we are facing here today. And if we have victory over the root of the problem, then the trees and the branches don't matter. Sometimes we think of Christianity as a selfish agenda by God, where he wanted to create a system and a people to just follow him. But if you look at the cross, you will see and understand that it was all for us. We are the beneficiaries of Calvary. Because when Christ ascended on the cross in Calvary and conquered sin, he conquered the root of the problem that we're facing here today. It is because of the cross that we have hope, that we can stand up and talk. It is because of the cross. And so the cross makes sense to everyone, Christian and non-Christian, because everyone who lives on earth faces the problems that are solved by the cross. And so God is holding out, waiting for just one person, just one more, to come into the fold. Just one more person who is crying like we are today, to have the hope of comfort, to have the hope of Revelation 21 verse 4 that says our tears will be wiped away. Just one more. To us who have already come to the cross, it feels as though he's delaying. But he looks at those who do not have hope of their tears being wiped away. And he says, I don't want them to cry and that be the end. And so I will hold out and just wait until just one more enters into the fold, so that they can have hope of experiencing the great reversal of all these problems that we're facing. We are told that there's going to be such a day of a great reversal, where the old will be given youthful vigor and strength, where those who have got feeble bodies will be strengthened again, where the dead will be brought back to life with bodies that do not die. There's a great day of reversal. And Christ is holding out for just one more. Just one to come into the fold. And that person may be here or outside, but he's going to continue holding out for just one more. John reports about that day in the book of Revelation. He says, the old was passed away, and behold, everything was made new. He says, there was no more death. There was no more sorrow, no more pain. There were no more tears. There was no more mourning and no more crying. For God will wipe away all our tears. And if you read in the book of Revelation, it says he will wipe away every tear from their eye. He records each one with each cause. He knows the things that cause us our sorrow and our pain. And on that great day, he will wipe it all away. We have victory over sin. But while he is still holding out, waiting for the just one more to enter into the fold, he does not leave us alone. Uhamba nathi. Umematula sakcika uyasiqinisa. Uma ebusuku ungakhoni kulala ukhona uhleti nawe. Uma umtimba ubuthakathaka uyikho divanga tsudziniwe, he's there. He's there with us the whole way until the day when we will see him again. Wasmith Masuku Nahlamini, you are not alone. He is with you through this journey. Let us pray. Our loving Father in heaven, I have just told your children that they are not alone because I have read it in your word. I pray, Heavenly Father, please do not make me a liar. Let them feel the comfort that I have promised them. Let them feel your presence in their daily lives. I have told them that when their knees are weak, you will strengthen them. Do it for them, Heavenly Father. This is my prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Ezwene lingashazwa emzino kanyayo auso zewakuka ubusugabuko guyosu lwinyembezi no
Siyabonga bazalwane sibonge nekumfundisi ngathi wayifunda lesilabhasi yesamari esikolweni kuthi bakunikete passage lenze bese bathi hayi igoqode uye ndemagama abembalo benginikeke passage lenze umfundisi wase ayigoqoda kodwa ukushito konke lobekufanele akusho in a few minutes time. Siyabonga bazalwane, we've now come to the end of our program. Siyabonga kubambisana kuze kufike lesikhathi. Ngitsemba sikaphuthi kakhulu batasixolela labadzala. Simemetelo nje lesinaso umsebenzi uyaqala kahlathi kusasa bathi la uqala ngabo 10. But I guess I'll tell you Barcelona, at least if we can be there at 9, so that in a Kaluako, Sikale Songe, Sesipelel. Sitao Tela was Labanema program, Bawashi la Pemyang. Sitao Tela was to see Lungi set in Yembe, an artist at South Tautsanjan, Nigelo, Nomakfanele Stelang and Billis, Kumselela, yes. But Sitao Kumselalana. Tinyembeti tekukhalela bakamasuku singahlabela nje ingoma sonke sendlule ngala sevana kude lophuma le sonke sendlula ngala indlela indlula ngasekhaya abazalwa amen
amasangwa likuku emzino khanyayo imkwaqo
Dingin and young, and see no car, yeah, you're in. suka bukho kuyo su kuyo su ninyembezi nokufa nezinsizi ayiba Kuyosulinye bezi, no gufa,